Hello everybody, this is K. Sudharani, school assistant, JPSS co-education Madhuguru from Bhadradri Kottagudem district of Telangana state. It has been nearly 6 months since we have met earlier. This COVID-19 pandemic situation has resulted many devastating effects in our educational standards, especially in our teaching methodology and assessment procedures. And not only that one, this pandemic situation has forced us to shift from chalk talk method to the one that involves technology. Okay, here almost all of the parents they show interest to buy smartphones or tabs to their children to meet the needs of educational issues. Okay, hence I would like to choose the method which students can feel at school. Children, shall we move to our video lesson? Come on, let us watch and enjoy our lesson. Hello children, welcome to our English teacher video lessons. How are you children? Okay, shall we go to the second slot today? What's our unit now? In which unit we are? Yeah, unit third. I'm reading A. Come on, tell me. Yeah, yes, for me is expected of school. Okay, in the previous session we have covered the inquiry made by the headmaster. Headmaster inquired nearly 5 students and they gave varied kinds of responses, no children. And we enjoyed all those responses and we experienced those type of experiences in our classrooms, no children, isn't it? Okay, now we shall move to the second slot, children. In the second slot, before going to the second slot, I would like to ask you a few questions, children. Come on, try to answer me. Okay, we have looked at the responses given by the children in Swami's class. Now let us come to our class, children. Suppose if you were absent the previous day, what type of responses would you give to your teacher? Come on, tell me, children. Come on, what type of responses would you give to your teacher in your classrooms? Come on, tell me. Responses given by you when you are absent. Come on, tell me. Think for a while. And you can use mother tongue also here. If you are not able to say it in English, you can answer in your mother tongue also. Come on, tell me. To the class teacher or headmaster. Generally, we class teachers ask you reasons for your absence. Come on, tell me. Reasons. Come on, tell me reasons. Come on. Yes. Yes. Some of the students, they keep quiet generally. This is what we observe in our classes also. And silent. You maintain silent. Both are same. Anyhow, okay, I shall write your responses here. And yes, murmurs. Yes, some of you murmurs. Yes, murmuring sound. Okay. And some of you, yes, stories, you need stories. Yes, you need stories, good. And stomachache, yes, stomachache or any other kinds of sickness. Yes, fever, good, okay. Sickness, it comes under fever only. Anyhow, for your sake, I am writing here. Okay, come on, tell me, what responses generally do you give in your class? What responses do you give? Come on, tell me. Yes, disjointed. Sometimes you give disjointed expressions. Disjointed expressions. That means it's not yet, not at all a meaningful sentences. Generally, you give responses, but those are not at all a meaningful sentence. Okay. Next, come on, give some more. Some of you are discreet, yes. Some of you maintain discreet. Discreet means you control your responses, yes. And some of you, come on, tell me, what type of responses you give generally? Yes, going or attending functions, yes. And yes, but some of you give
responses, but those responses are not at all correct. Some of you give false prayers, false answers. Some of your responses are false. Okay, those are not correct, incorrect. Incorrect, you can say incorrect response, incorrect. Your responses are not correct, incorrect, okay? Now, generally these expressions or these responses you give to us children, generally in our classes also the same thing happens. Now let us look at the Swami's responses now. Headmaster, now it's Swami's turn. Headmaster came to Swami and asked him, what did he do the previous day and why did he keep away from the school? Then Swami's response was speechless. He did not answer anything. He kept quiet. And his silence made headmaster more and more angry. So he took a stick and gave a rap on Swami. But even though Swami did not respond to the back, next again he headmaster asked Swami, "What you are keeping quiet? Suppose if you keep quiet and stay like that at me, I shall beat you. I shall give you more raps." But no response again. Here Swami's eyes fell upon the another student who was sitting in front of him on the third bench, and that student he was looking at the blackboard, and his attention was completely towards the blackboard, that boy's attention. But Swami standing there, he could see the back of Rajan's head and pink ears, and he was feeling ashamed. Suppose Rajan comes his head, what would be his situation? He wanted to jump down from the desk to the floor. And such kind of expressions were going on in his mind. And suppose the headmaster comes to him, then the headmaster, looking at his silence, watching his silence, he gave another rap. And the rap made him, brought him again to himself. That means he became conscious of his presence here. Swami became conscious of his presence. Okay, children? Now, tell me, what would be the headmaster response? Again, he was staring. He was staring, means looking. Looking at the headmaster without uttering any word. And at the same time, he was, yes, what was he doing? He was massaging. Massaging the pain. Because he got many raps, you know, by the headmaster. So, he was massaging and his eyes filled with tears, tearful eyes. His eyes were tearful. You know, tearful eyes means when our eyes filled with tears, we say those eyes are tearful eyes, children. So sometimes you do also give these type of expressions, tearful eyes. Okay, children. Now, here also Swami's condition was helpless. Then headmaster again asked him. He wanted to give that he was suffering from headache, but that answer was already given by the student who was sitting beside him. No use. And he wanted to knit a story, but disjointed expressions, many disjointed expressions streamed in his mind. But he could not utter even a single word because he was discreet enough. He was clever enough not to utter those words. So again, headmaster beat him and he received many laughs, but again, Swami's response was silence. So finally, headmaster sent a boy to fetch Pune from the office room. He fetched Pune came into the classroom and headmaster asked the Pune, "Come on, tell me, what did this boy do yesterday?" Then the Pune said that, "What did he say? You can look. You can go through your passages and see the responses, interaction that has gone between headmaster Pune and Swami here. It was very nice. And here, what did he do that previous day? Swami broke the pens, window pens. And whose pens were those? Headmaster's pens. Yes, headmaster's window pens. Swami broke that pens. So he was furious. Headmaster was very furious. And Swami could not do anything because it was a mysterious thing done by the done by our student Swami, done by Swami. So he could not say anything. He could not try to defend himself. Why? Because it was the fact. So headmaster asked him to stand at the desk till he announced the punishment. And what was the punishment? Suspension from the school. So, but he received many bags on his body and massaging all the bags, and each and every pore started to burn on his body. And so finally he gutted himself and he took all the books and muttering himself, "Oh, I don't like this dirty school," saying that he went away. He came out of the school. That was about our Swami Chidan. You can enjoy. You go through the passages once again. This rot 2. And you know where we have ended this rot 1. And you go through this rot 2 from here. When Swaminathan's turn came, he looked around helplessly. And from there to the last paragraph. "Yes, I don't care for your dirty school." Go through all these passages, children. And if you are not able to understand any particular word, underline those words and look the words up in the dictionary, or you can have your glossary, children. You take the help of this glossary. With the help of this glossary and with the dictionary, you go through all those passages. It will be very clear to you, children. Okay? Is it clear? Come on, go through the passages twice or thrice. After that, I shall ask you a few questions. Children, have you gone through the passages? Shall I ask you questions? Okay, come on, answer me. Why did the headmaster send for the pure children? Come on, answer me. Why did the headmaster send for the pure? Yes. Pure had noticed. That's for me. Yes. Pune had noticed that Swami breaking the window panes the previous day. Headmaster's window panes. That good. Okay. Now, come on, try to give me answer for the next question. Swami muttered, "I don't care for your dirty school," no? Why did he say so? Come on, tell me. Why did Swami say, "I don't care for your dirty school"? Yes, he did not like the school. Why? Yes, he received many wax on his body. Yes, and there was no means of escaping. Yes, for the mistake he had done the previous day. So, he, saying so, he left the school. Very good. Okay. Chilan, very nice. Okay. Go, tomorrow, we can go for another slot, Chilan. Thank you.